First of all, I will take my watch on the table. Put it on the table. You gave me 20 minutes, but Steve, we made an agreement that I say
was
when
that
I.
Agreement?
Yeah, it was an agreement. I think so. Yeah, well, I say when I start because I have to say some words in front of that. only some. Yeah. Well, you asked me to come to this place. By the way, all the best wishes from. Christa Larsen from Malmö, where I was yesterday. Your words, George, what did you say? Bristol should be on everybody's tongue is a fabulous one. That's fantastic. I'm circling now very much around Europe. In which way does it work? Like that? No? Like that? No?
Yes.
This way? Other way? Here we are. I'm circling now a lot in Europe. I'm out of my job. I made it 30 years in Freiburg. Continuity, sensibility, and quality were always my words, which I told. You know, there were some big bangs. It was 1972 when Club of Rome wrote Limits to Growth. It was 92. Two, when the Rio conference took place. It was 97, and this is an important date because the Kyoto Protocol was signed. Also Britain signed it. We said in between 20 years we all should reduce our CO2 emissions by about 20%. That's a fact. There was another conference 20 years later, and also the CO2 emissions are not going to be reduced. They are going more on and on and on. And it's also a fact that America took in 2001, took his signature away. A lot of things has happened in between, a lot of catastrophes around the world. This year's was in your region, Somerset was flooded, flooding of Wales. In Germany, the flooding in the Elbe area. The hurricanes which hit the Philippines, which hit, of course, also America very hard. These temperature which went down for 3 months in northern America, what they never had before. And I was invited to US 6 weeks before. I had big discussions with all those persons there around Chicago. And one point becomes clearer and clearer for me. George, we need persons to be the motor. But we have to engage the younger ones. The elder ones will not change. Same procedure as last year. Will be only very, very few. Very, very few. They are talking and talking and talking, but the younger ones, they can bring it. When you look now to on this card, I haven't yet started, Steve. Yeah? when you look on this card, a lot of cities are doing a good thing. Countries, governments cannot do really a lot of things. In Germany, a lot of things happened. In France, a lot of things happened. Even in Spain, a lot of things happened. In Scandinavia, a lot of things happened. Yeah. And when I look to Britain, perhaps this doesn't happen because you are so much centralized governed. This must be the cities where the idea is coming from. In Germany, the mayors are very strong. And I give all my help to you that you will be a tiger afterwards, huh? Really strong person. I made my way in February, I think, with Peter Hall around Britain. I saw those places like Blackpool. I could not believe it, what happened there. Saw it last time when I was in the 60s. And he took me also to newer places like Abbotsleigh, and it was not understandable for me, such areas where you created an open public point for tram a train station, and nothing was anywhere around. Huh? And I looked in this direction, that direction, nothing was around. And this is my first point, and now I will start. See? It's my first point. Mayors should have, what did I write down this morning? Should have as legal possibility every year 150 kilos of dynamite to blow the most worst buildings up without getting jailed afterwards. Yeah? So when we are now going and looking to, it's this machine again, now I start, looking to your city, it's a fabulous one. You have everything you need. A river in the middle, a population around 430,000 inhabitants has this size that you have a brilliant overview. You are close to the sea, you are not flat, some mountains are inside. You have the university, and there are the younger people. And you should engage these younger people. I was so astonished when we made this ship tour. Thank you very much for your explaining that so many buildings around this fantastic area are totally not underused, they are not used. Huh? Why is it not possible? Or why is it possible that in London no one gets any flat, you have to pay millions and millions, and here you have in the brilliant area, most brilliant area, you have these houses which are not used. Why aren't you putting university and students inside though that the young ones are inside the city? The colorful picture must be inside the city. That is why with Kevin Murray we gave you at that time the advice when the election was not to build the new university outside as a campus, install it inside. Bring younger people inside. And the younger people are making terribly interesting things. They are all on internet. And this internet plays a more and more important role. All information they can get about cities, they get it in between 10 minutes. They check it through, like a woman checks a man when she comes in a bar. Is he okay or is he not okay? It happens in 5 minutes. Huh? A woman does it in 5 seconds. Huh? But it happens in five minutes. And then these young people decide where to go. I give you another advice, George. Look at your website of Bristol. Take the best office you can get and make a fabulous, fabulous website for Bristol. Best office you can get. I want to point out four points: traffic, private, and open public. Combined to it, of course, the quality of open space. Then I want to talk about living and working, and some words about participation, and also some words about organization. And I will hope now in 20 minutes. First point is when you come, you enter a city. I came yesterday. This is the first view of Bristol. Is it really inviting, or is it in this way that you say, oh, where I am here? Huh? Where I am here? Why aren't you bringing up ideas in which way this can be created? Not the developers. You must have the ideas. Huh? And then you look for some persons who can do it. But the city must have the, well, you must have the power to tell them what they should do, and not they tell them they only invest here when you do this and those things. Traffic. This picture I've taken in a hotel when I was in London in February. Left-hand side, the cars are killing everything, as we heard. When we are not able to reduce these car movements, and that's the next one, I hope you have a plan from Bristol. How much traffic is only running through your areas without touching any organization, any shop, any living area or so on? I think you can reduce a lot of cars inside. And you can also reduce a lot of cars. You must start, not only tell, you must start, bring away parking places. And those parking places which exist must be paid. And you have also given a good advice at this point, all your staff who is working in your authorities do not get a parking place for free. They have to pay, that it hurts, £50 a week. We did it in Freiburg. You said 95% didn't come with this car. They took the open public transportation system. You cannot say, I want to get washed, but don't make me wet. These are those who are in the authorities who take the leadership in it. The leadership. Picture of Freiburg. The city of the future is dense and compact. It is, of course, the city of the suburbs. There where most of the people are living, there you have installed all your creativity. It is also the city of social mixture. Beware the social mixture. The social problems will be one of the most we have in the next years. Not separation, integration, job creating, like Jamie Lerner did a long time in Curitiba. He made a fantastic job in a city where you really couldn't think that it could work. It's, of course, a city of culture, not only paid culture, the open space, and then it comes. When you take the cars away, you have more open space. The open space is for everyone, also for not paid culture, cultural events. Education and job creating. It is a city of innovation, of science, and participation. And all that must be combined to an open public transportation system which runs often, which is clean, which is safe, and is cheap. In this way, we did it about 30 years. I went to Freiburg in beginning of 83 and had to leave at the end of 2012. You need a second life as a planner, huh? This would be great, yeah? So we combined all these functions which we created inside the air, very close to the open public transportation line. So the running costs are a big problem. By bringing the density very close to the open public transportation line, and by reducing the car parking places, we also built smaller malls inside, not outside. Malls is another problem. I will not talk about that. We could talk the whole afternoon about malls. It's the most stupid thing in life. Huh? You can reduce the car parking places extremely when you allow to build or you enforce to build closer up to the tram line. That means we get it in this way that 85% of all costs of the running system are covered by the tickets. The highest amount you have in Europe. Means year by year, day by day, month by month, decades by decades, try to install all those housings, all those offices, all those open public institutes very close to the tram line and to reduce the car parking places which they normally need. We have a law in Germany which says per 40 square meters one car parking place. I said it's totally wrong. The law is made in Berlin, and Berlin is very far away from Freiburg. Huh? So are you able to do this by yourself, or is the point that the centralization here tells you what you have to do, and if it's so, you have to change this fact. The transportation system, it's a network. You have it too, but what you don't have, what I've seen, you don't have these lines for buses. They must run. Bus line and bicycle lines, they must run. And the car, driving cars through, they must stay. You must bring them in another direction. The entrance of the city. This is our station. Only 230,000 inhabitants. It was a competition. It was also a developer. But we made the competition, and not the developer made it. He had to pay for that. And we enforced him in which way he had to go. You see, no cars, bicycles inside. And you see also the touch-to-touch, you don't have a tramline system, but you can do bring all the open public transportation system and the bicycle systems together, and then build houses. Since the 1st January of 2011, all houses have to be built as passive houses. Not can be built, have to be built. Yeah? It's a law, a city law. But you must imagine 85% of all existing, no, only 15% are new built areas. You have also to think about it, in which way you can go, what can you realize, in which way you can work to bring another system in the already built areas. Now they are doing separate decentralized heating areas, heating stations, and biogas management. City should be dense. Not one developer does everything. One point which I have seen during my stay here in England now for a longer time, it was amazing. I worked in the 60s as a window cleaner in Derbyshire. It was so fantastic. We're very close to the people. To be close to the people is one of the most important things, huh? To listen to them. Huh? It is in this way that we have a possibility to freeze the price, that not the speculation. Is that a point where the land is sold to those persons who pay most of the money? No, we have a possibility to freeze on a certain amount the price. No? And if it's not possible here, you have to fight for that as mayor. It was Nick Bowles who came to Freiburg and wanted to see me. It was September last year. He came with two very nice ladies, private secretaries. One was left side, one right side. We had a totally day together, and he was very amazed about a lot of things. And he only said, "No, this cannot happen in Britain." And I told him, "Well, when you see, and it's fabulous for you, why can that not happen? It is you. You have to make it happen." And after a long, long discussion, he said, we started at 11, and it was 7 or 8 in the early evening. And he said, "Well, you convinced me in this way. I have to talk with the Prime Minister Cameron." I never heard anything again. Huh? Never. No notice, no letter, nothing, nothing, nothing. I spent more than a half a day with him. Huh? What about the traffic?
We apologize on his behalf.
Perhaps you write me a letter afterwards. Do you see? By installing new areas, the first element which has to run is the open public transportation system. Not the cars. The car circulation is only 30 kilometers per hour here. And only one car parking place per unit, not two or three or four, one car parking place per unit. So then you win the open space, and the open space is so necessary, what you two told, just for the children, for those who need it, for the elder persons, huh? Those who are not so mighty. Huh? Our car system. I took this for in reality. We didn't put these bobby cars together. It's the area of Vauban. Vauban is a car-free area, or a car very, very reduced area. As I always tell, normally you have, for 1,000 inhabitants, you have 500 to 650 cars. In Freiburg, we have around 410, 420. And in this area, Vauban, we have only 85 cars for 1,000 inhabitants. So you have the open space for the people. And something very interesting happened, George. This is, perhaps it's very necessary for your discussion. The Pope came to Freiburg 3 years ago. I wanted to show him the church where we made this church combined, Roman Catholics and Protestants. Ecumene, but he didn't want to see that. No, 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 he did, really didn't want to see it. But the point was, before he came, and on the day he was there, in the whole city, no car circulation was allowed. Nothing at all. They stopped it. And nothing happened. Nothing happened. Huh? Nothing happened. So all these persons who say, well, when you do this and that and those, the world is going down. No, it's not true. What is lifestyle? Bring inside the open public transportation system, make it dense. When you talk to these Chinese friends and say density, they are laughing. Huh? But you see the quality of open space. Huh? The quality of open space. This is the fortune, the future. And by the way, it's not for the old ones. We have to, of course, we have to take care about the old ones. But the young ones are those who are bringing the future to us. And be careful. Look at your country and look also at your city where the young persons are going to. In Finland, for example, is a big movement to Copenhagen and to Hamburg. In Sweden, from the north, everyone goes in direction to Stockholm and to Malmö and to also to Copenhagen. In Germany is a movement from the west, from the east to the west, from the north to the south. So offer something that this city will be a city for younger people, for innovation, for the young ones, not the old ones. Huh? Make it like that. The streets are for the children. When this sign is on the street, the car has to stand still. And they say, when they move, the car can go on. Huh? It's in front of my house. They make a row over the, I will tell it, row over the street and say to you, €2, and then you can pass. Huh? Or open space. Huh? Open space. That is quality of life. Huh? That is quality of life. And from my opinion, when you are going into a city, close your eyes, you open your eyes, and then say, in which city I am? Where are the signals the city is sending? Huh? And you have so much chances here in Bristol because you have this river, you have these old areas, you must build very, very new one. When we went through yesterday, there were some good ones, but there were some very terrible ones. That's why I would like to give him the 100 kilo of dynamite. Huh? Leisure ground, all combined also to open access for the computer. The young people want to have it. And those cities are making the run which offer it for free. How many money is blown up in the wind by any shit, huh? And why aren't we taking that? How do we want to live in future? It's an installation in Vienna, but it's not only, 2 minutes ago, yeah. Yeah, two minutes, yeah. It's an installation which is not so stupid. In Vienna, students did it. Build up a framework, make inside the installation of all technology, and let the people do what they want, and after 20 years, when everything is broken, you smash everything away. Or here, it's in Helsinki. They build platforms, and everyone could do on his platform what he liked to do. We are far away from these models. We are far away. But our idea was to create areas for cooperating houses. No developers inside. This reduces the price around 30 to 40%. It's not the price they need for the organization, it's the price they can win when they sell something. All units have totally different ground floors. You can move the walls away. Everything is in passive house style. And also these houses where you don't can see which one is ownership, private owned, which one is rented, and which one is social housing. The social stabilization plays an important role. You have some examples here. Huh? You have some examples. Huh? You have some examples. This is, for my opinion, it's a very good one. But I'm very sure it's only privatized. Should be 1/3 social housing, 1/3 rented, and 1/3 privatized. Also the alternative sort of living we integrated inside. Those people, when they cannot afford to pay for the rent, they have to work in it. They work, they make the garden, they go kitchen in the restaurant, which is close by. Houses from the end of 60s, beginning 70s, we turned them into passive houses. This is now a passive house. Worldwide, the first passive house. I can talk about the price. It's 1,630 euro per square meter. And we reduced the energy consumption by about 85 to 90% because when they opened the window. Living areas. Restore them from the 60s. Build new ones for me from now 2010. And also a mixture inside. Working and living. You could do that in your old buildings here along the river, these ruins. You only have to imagine it. We can talk about that hours and hours. All passive houses, it's a mixture of smaller units. The big ones will not come. It's time now to go. Integration of population, integration also of the younger people, the green areas. Never build them, never make them by yourself. Let the people make the green areas, like Christa Larsen does it now also in Malmö. This has the impact that no demolishment will take place. When the people have done this area by themselves, no demolishment will take place. Why did I tell you this all? Look about our organization. The time of bosses is over. We need smaller leadership. You in history, you beat the Spanish Armada, which had mighty ships with very small units, with very small ships. And that is why the small ones, the small groups must steer it through. Cities are always the result of their political culture, of their employees who are working for it, the authorities, of the organizations which are inside, and of course of the population. And I kindly ask you to integrate the younger ones. The younger ones, these are the persons you have to integrate, and you ask them to ask them, how do you want to live in future? Now we'll stop because you said it's time to go. It's very hard for me to go now because I just... I have one point for George personally. I brought a bottle of wine. Of course, it comes from the region of wine. This bottle made a tour to Italy first, then to Finland, then to Sweden and to Denmark, and now it's here. It was very hard, not in Italy. Italy was a lot of wine, but in the Scandinavian areas, the alcohol was so expensive that I had several times when I was staying in my hotel room, which was a terrible one, I said, well, why should I not drink that? No, I bring it to you because this is sunshine. You need better, more sunshine here. And I gave my card, and I can only say, if you have problems, perhaps you drink a glass, and if the problems are not over, you drink a second glass. And if the problems are not over, there is my mail address on site. And if then you have only three problems and you call me, then you have four or five or six problems more. But I hope you will make the race here. And if you need help in any way, you can all the time contact me. Thank you very much.